morning, Thursday, 26th of July. On a second day here in Samarkand, we have to see some more sites here. We'll start with the mosque that we saw yesterday in the evening. We'll just have a quick look at that. Then the Bibi-Kahnym Mausoleum, and then there is an observatory we can see. So let's go and have a look at that.
Okay, back once again at the Bibi-Kahnym Mosque here. We'll start here, get some pictures of it on this side in the sunlight. And get some pictures inside of the dome. We didn't see that yesterday evening. It's a bit too dark. We'll do that first and then move on to the next place. Just going to show you inside here. You can see the signs of the earthquake that destroyed this. So Timur, the great Mongolian conqueror, he ordered this to be built in a record time of 5 years. And maybe it went a little bit too fast because the construction is not that strong. You see, it's fell into ruins, even though they're starting to rebuild most of it now. So you can see here there used to be a staircase that used to go there. Inside we can actually they're renovating the mosque here and the dome, but actually still getting through this door here. Meters to the top there.
Okay, this mosque have, you can see here where they have a big crack, and that is for the earthquakes. And now you can see where the earthquakes have been.
Now this has been destroyed by earthquakes. You can still see the cracks in the wall.
Big crack over there.
Just really pleased that they have renovated a lot of the mosques, because if they all look like this in ruin, never have no idea what they used to look like in their former glory with all the blue tiles. And so it's nice to see that they've renovated some of them. Also four minarets in the corners. Only one of them is original. The other three are new. This one here is a new one. Dramatic change that Samarkand has gone through.
See, all this that has been restored. It's just been painted on the walls. It looks like a wallpaper, but it's not. It's actually just painted on the wall. So some people must have just had a job just sitting. You're painting all these buttons. Must have taken ages. You can see the uneven and oops, and the pencil lines and that.
Just across the street here from the Bibi-Kahnym Mosque is the mausoleum where Bibi-Kahnym's family, her mother, are buried here. I think two other members of her family. Let's go and have a quick look. Next attraction here in Samarkand is the Shah-i-Zinda Islamic complex. Let's go and have a look at this. So this complex of Islamic buildings and mausoleums actually includes the mausoleum of the cousin of Muhammad. This is supposed to be a very important Islamic religious site, full of interesting architecture. Let's go and have a look. Thank you. selection of mausoleums. Some of them are dedicated to the family of Timur. Timur, he was the ruler of Central Asia. The man that built the mosque that we saw yesterday and this morning. His sisters are buried here in these mausoleums.
Calm down my head a bit. I'm like doing mindfulness. Just a funny little comment. You notice that a lot of these Uzbek people, they have gold teeth. A lot of them. Very unusual compared to what we see in Europe.
This is Mirza Ulugbek, a descendant of Timur, and this is his observatory here, which was used to make scientific calculations. Let's go and have a look here. So now we're just inside the museum here at the observatory. Here you can just see just how big the empire was that Amiet Timur, he ruled over. You can see now we have Samarkand, but this this area goes all the way into India and all the way over here, Turkey, including Iran, Iraq, Uzbekistan, all included in his vast empire. Here you can see the descendants of Amir Timur. This is when he was born, this is when he became king, and this is when he died. Here you can see he had four children. One of his descendants was Ulugbek. And his, we're here in his observatory here. Then we have another descendant here, Mirza Babur. Babur, he actually went to India, and he was the ruler of India. You can see a map of the Silk Road. Here we are in Samarkand, which is halfway along the Silk Road, which from here you see Rum, which is modern day Istanbul in Turkey, all the way to China. This is Beijing. And you can also see some of the cities we visited on the way. That must be Tehran, Esfahan. We didn't go to Shiraz, but now we're back on the route here. There's Buxara, which we know as Bukhara, and now we're in Samarkand. Now you can see the Silk Road goes from different. There's not just one Silk Road, there's many Silk Roads. The yellow one is the main one. They also go down here to India this way. And there's a north and a south Silk Road here. This is in China there. Background, you can see the mosque where we were yesterday, and outside the mosque is a bazaar. It's actually a bazaar today. It doesn't look like this though, but we'll probably go there tomorrow. There's a modern day bazaar. Well, this is a model of the observatory. You can see the light coming here through the window and showing onto these rails that are 11 meters underground and 40 meters above the ground. And they would mark the position of the sun each day at noon. And with those calculations, they had the we're able to work out the exact duration of 1 year. And you can see, there's Ulugbek's calculation, how accurate he was compared to the present day calculation. But they say even that minor misalignment is actually due to the change in the constellation and the planets at the moment. And you can see a painting that's been made later of some of the most important astronomers of the years. Here you have Ulugbek, but also here, somebody you may know in Denmark, Tukul Bra is shown here on the picture here. You can also see this is actually the aerial sea, which used to feed Uzbekistan with water. It's two major rivers, but since the 50s, Russia has been feeding this water to feed all of their cotton fields with overproduction. That means that Uzbekistan doesn't have access to any water. The aerial sea is actually dried up. I've read it's actually been partly regenerated now in Kazakhstan. This the aerial sea is shared by Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan. There's a new museum we've just seen that they've built. Here we go and see the remains of what is left of the observatory. Only thing we can see now is the rails that go below the ground. Again, here you can see the remains of the rails that used to be used to mark the position of the sun during noontime.
We've seen the Uzbek people doing like this, and we wonder what that meant. So we asked the guide here, and he says they do this at funeral, and therefore also when they enter mausoleums, they do that, but also maybe before or after eating, and that means I believe.
Okay, now we are on a new restaurant, and now we are trying to eat a little bit more modern today.
More European.
Yeah, not so international food in Uzbekistan. This is more European.
And we actually feel a little bit cold, and it is fantastic.
Would have known this in the middle of Uzbekistan. They sing happy birthday.
So that was the end of today. We've just been to a nice restaurant. It was a bit European style, which was quite nice, and they spoke English. Which is also nice to try traditional things, but it was also nice with some well-known thing. Tomorrow we are here in Samarkand again, another day, see if we can find things to do here. And then I'll say I had a very fun experience today. We went to one of the sightseeing places, and I met this woman we had a selfie with that you can see on the video and on the photos, older woman in a red dress and a golden scarf, and it was just so strange. It was just a strange person we just met and had a photo with, but it just felt like I had some sort of connection with her, that I knew her, and I just felt like cuddling her. And when we met her again, like 10 minutes later, this another place inside, she was also looking at me in a strange way. It was very, very strange, like I knew her like it was my grandmother or something, or maybe a guardian angel or something. Very strange feeling. So that was just a very strange feeling. Can't really explain it at all. But anyway, good night here from Samarkand again. Tomorrow we have another day in Samarkand, so we'll see if we can find something to do. It might be a massage tomorrow.